ආවත්‍රව්‍ය බහැර කිරීම පිළිබඳව සඳහන් කළා එතුමන් සඳහන් කරද්දී කතා කරා මේ අරුවක්කාළු ප්‍රශ්නය පිළිබඳව මේ අරුවක්කාළු ප්‍රශ්නයේදී අමාත්‍ය මණ්ඩලයේදීත් ඒ වගේම වෙනත් අවස්ථාවලදීත් මාත් ඒ වගේම රිෂාඩ් බදියුදීන් ඇමතිතුමා රංග බණ්ඩාර මන්ත්‍රීතුමා ඒ වගේම අප්පුහාමි මන්ත්‍රීතුමා වැනි අය ඒ පිළිබඳව ඒ පළාතේ ජනතාවගේ විරෝධය පිළිබඳව සඳහන් කරලා තිබෙනවා. ඒ පළාතේ ජනතාව විතරක් නෙවෙයි ඒ පළාතේ ඉන්න හැම ආගමක නායකවරු පවා මේ පිළිබඳව දැඩි විරෝධයක් එල්ල කරන අවස්ථාවේදී ඒ ව්‍යාපෘතිය ක්‍රියාත්මක කිරීමට පෙර සාකච්ඡාවක් ජනාධිපතිතුමන් එවැගේම අග්‍රාමාත්‍යතුමන් එකතුව ඒ පළාතේ ජනතාවගේ නියෝජිතයන්ට ලබා දී යුතුයි කියලා මම ඉල්ලා සිටිනවා. මොකද මේක බැරෑරුම් ප්‍රශ්නයක්. මොකද දීර්ඝ කාලයක් තිස්සේ මේ ප්‍රශ්නය පිළිබඳව ජනතාවගේ උද්ඝෝෂණ පවත්වනවා. ඒ උද්ඝෝෂණය පැවැත්වීමට ඒ ක්‍රියාත්මක කරන්නට යද්දී ඒ විෂයභාර අමාත්‍යතුමා ඒ අවශ්‍ය පාර්ශ්වයත් එක්ක හරි හැටියට සාකච්ඡා කරලා කරුණු පහදා දීලා ඒ කළ යුතුයි. අපි පිළිගන්නවා විද්‍යාත්මකව කරන ක්‍රමවේදයක් වුණත් විශේෂයෙන්ම මේ සැනිටරි ලෑන්ඩ්ෆිල් කියන ඒ සංකල්පය හරියාකාරයට ක්‍රියාත්මක වුණත් ඒ පිළිබඳව ජනතාවට තියෙන සැකය අපි තොරන් කර යුතුයි. ඒ පිළිබඳව සාකච්ඡාව ලබා දිය යුතුයි. ඒ සඳහා ගරු ජනාධිපතිතුමන් එවැගේම අග්‍රාමාත්‍යතුමන් දෙපළම එකතු වෙලා ඒ පළාතේ ජනතාවගේ නියෝජිතයන්ටත් ඒ සිවිල් සමාජයේ නායකයන්ටත් ඒ සාකච්ඡාව වහාම ලබා දිය යුතුයි කියලා මම ඉල්ලා සිටිනවා. ඒත් සමගම තව කාරණා කීපයක් සඳහන් කළ යුතුයි. විශේෂයෙන්ම about I need to talk about shifting of armed forces camps in the north and the east. There has been an attempt at shifting camps, and particularly when the civilian communities are affected by the situation of several camps in the north and the east where private lands are involved. Now there is a particular question. There is a continuous agitation going on in the town of Silavathurai for the last few weeks. The Silavathurai town has entirely been taken over by the Navy to set up a camp as late as 2009. After the war had come to an end, this Navy camp had been situated. They had identified the entire town comprising of 60 shops, a police station, a mosque, then there is the Pradeshiya Sabha library, 181 houses. These are all caught up within the Silavathurai Navy camp, and this is a preposterous situation. And we have in fact made several attempts to bring this to the notice of the authorities and to look at an alternate location for the Navy camp to be shifted from there. Not only that, the main landing point for the fishermen has also been encroached by the setting up of the Navy camp. Now this issue has to be resolved, and I beg that the President would look into this matter and see that all these private lands which have been taken over to set up the camp, there are 181 private deeds that are available. Some deeds are going back to the early part of the last century. So this is a very serious situation. I hope that the naval authorities will look into this. And similarly, when it comes to the army, there is this attempt to shift the Murakattanchena camp in the eastern province in the Kalkuda electorate. The Murakattanchena camp, which had been set up, this is the artillery regiment that has been stationed there. There has been an attempt by certain interested parties to shift this away onto the Batiklo electorate. Now they have tried to, whereas the earlier a decision had been made very clearly that the commanding officer of the 231 brigade had discussed this matter with the former GA Charles, who had subsequently been the Director General of Customs. When she was GA Batiklo, they identified the most suitable land for relocation was to be the Hadi estate within the same Kiran Divisional Secretary Division. And having overlooked all the decisions that have been made officially, now there is an attempt by certain unscrupulous elements, certain interested parties, to shift this on to the Eravur Divisional Secretary Division. Now, this is a very serious matter because they have identified the Punnakuda area. The Punnakuda area is one of the pristine beaches. I would say next to even better than Pasikuda. Punnakuda is an area where tourism development could take place. The Honorable Tourism Development Minister is here. And this is a pristine beach which can be developed. And there has been certain interested parties who had already set up their lands there. But abutting that, there are some LRC lands, Land Reform Commission owned lands, which are earmarked to set up an industrial zone. This had been done by
Honorable the Minister, you can past. Get yes, sir, any 2 minutes on.
Therefore, I would request that this decision to shift, this has been, there is an unscrupulous person by the name of, he has given me, no, already taken. So therefore, this issue, the LRC officer of the area has, now that I would like to table the letter by Honorable Sayyid Alizahir Maulana, the Honorable State Minister, who comes from the area. He has written this letter to Mr. Srimevan Dias, Chairman of the Land Reform Commission. I table the letter. This letter contains all the details about how this particular gentleman called one Vimal Raj, who is the LRC officer in that area, unscrupulously he is trying to shift this onto this particular area, which is a tourism and development zone, and this is the only land available for expansion of the highly congested village called Eravur, which has almost 35,000 population living in a very limited land space. And therefore, that issue has to be considered with all seriousness that it deserves. Thank you very much, Mr. Chair.